All right. Thank you, everybody, for coming to our 2 o'clock session. We have our session Equity Matters and Community College Libraries. NCCCLA Equity Subcommittee takes the challenge. And our speakers today are Brittany Champion from Pitt Community College and Colleen Kehoe Robinson from James Sprunt Community College. A couple of housekeeping things to remember. We are recording this session. For this session, we will stop recording at the point where we move into question and answer. The session also has closed caption enabled. If you want to turn that off, at the bottom of your screen, you'll see an arrow next to Live Transcript CC. Click that, select Hide Subtitles, and the closed captioning will go away. Because we are recording the sessions, I also want to make sure that you understand that does include the chat, and that even includes private chats. So anything in the chat box will be included in the transcript of this session. And I will be monitoring the chat, so you can feel free to ask questions there, but we will have a, like I said, a question and answer session after the formal part of the presentation. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to Colleen and Brittany.
Thank you. Thank you. You kind of covered all the housekeeping that I had already in my mind, so I'm really happy about that. Colleen and I would like to thank you all so much for being here today with us and hearing what we have to say about the great works of the Sub-Equity Committee. I'm really excited to kind of say that technically we're a committee, we just have to go through the official ropes. So that's why you see Equity Subcommittee before you, but we're ready to talk about it. Colleen, if you're ready, you tell me.
I am ready. And thank you again, everyone, for the invitation.
So today, we are going to talk about the details regarding the Equity Subcommittee's equity statement to brainstorm some innovative ideas and action plans to cultivate an equitable space in community college libraries, and also to identify additional equity resources needed to support community college library professionals, because you can never have too much support.
To get started, we wanted to briefly talk about the history. We were founded on December 15th of 1967 as the North Carolina Community College Library Association, NCCCLA. We underwent a series of name changes through the years to accommodate the ever-evolving role of the library in North Carolina community colleges. Known as the North Carolina Community College Learning Resources Association for several decades, the organization came full circle in 2014, when once again, we adopted the name of North Carolina Community College Library Association.
So our mission is to provide a variety of professional development and networking opportunities for North Carolina Community College librarians, library paraprofessionals, and others who have interest in North Carolina Community College libraries, and that others mean LIS students as well.
So we would like to take just a minute to ask two questions. One, what does equity look like to you? And two, what does equity look like to your library?
And this is an opportunity, if you want to put your comment in the chat or you want to use your mic, you're more than welcome to do so. Well, I can start first by saying that what equity comes down to, despite all of these definitions, what it looks like to me is just overall fairness, and fairness to everyone who uses the library, whether it's electronic resources, print resources, you know, just attending our programs and our outreach initiatives. Fairness is what it boils down to for me. And we have some things coming through on the chat. I'm gonna see if I can bring that up so I can see it. And Holly says, providing access to everyone, no matter, fair access to our patrons. And again, that again just boils down to fairness and making it equal for all. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and jump into this next slide. So we know what equity looks like to you and what it looks like to your library, but let's talk about the brainstorming in behind the equity statement. So group work, we met every week to discuss the statement, what we hoped that the audience would be able to perceive from what we were writing. After completing the statement, we held meetings a little bit more infrequently, but strategically, we established these groups to better focus on segments of the statement. Each meeting, we spent countless time going over every detail, including the wording, formatting, punctuation, and grammar, of course. But what I will say about working in the groups is that I learned a lot. From my peers, I learned a lot about what equity looked like to them and to their library. And what was so great about this partnership was that we got to work with the executive board. Elizabeth and myself, we met with the board several times and we allowed members to share their concerns. We shared details about, you know, setbacks or things that we felt like we needed to include in the statement. And we always got positive feedback, but we got honest feedback. So that was really good for us moving forward. And I really appreciated that partnership from the executive board.
The collaboration within the committee provided lots of benefits, and those benefits included improving time management, limiting stress and independent work. Working in teams helped to build trust and understanding of individual strengths, as well as learning about practices at other North Carolina community college libraries. And within the groups, communicating with members, we were able to learn more about equity initiatives in other CCL and needs that we had not addressed. Those needs that we had identified help us to brainstorm action plans to produce after the equity statement development phase.
So I'm going to go through and read this statement. And I will make it bigger so everyone can see. Equity statement. North Carolina Community College Library Association seeks to raise awareness of the need to provide access to opportunities, resources, and support for all members of the communities we serve, and to build a platform from which marginalized members of our communities can share their voices. All users have a right to feel safe in a welcoming environment that will foster opportunities for academic success and encourage integrity. We acknowledge equity, diversity, and inclusion as foundational principles of librarianship. It is critical for library communities to recognize and practice cultural awareness and condemn discrimination. NCCCLA will empower all library staff and our community partners to model and promote these principles in advancing issues of fairness and social justice. We remind our communities that libraries are for everyone, and we will continue to serve all users. North Carolina Community College Library Association Equity Subcommittee facilitates the association's commitment to equity for North Carolina Community College Libraries. The subcommittee makes recommendations to the NCCCLA Executive Board and coordinates approved equity initiatives. These initiatives include advancement, recruitment and retention, dignity and respect, and fair and supportive work environments for marginalized groups in the library profession. In addition, the subcommittee supports initiatives to promote social justice for members of our communities, both those served by and those serving in North Carolina Community College libraries. Moreover, the subcommittee is guided by the following core values. Access. to resources, services, and opportunities that are fully inclusive of the diversity, including but not limited to race, ethnicity, gender, gender identity, gender expression, sexual orientation, national origin, disability, and economic status, embodied by our current and future NC Community College libraries or users. Action, to bridge equity gaps, raise awareness, and amplify the voices of marginalized groups through the development of practical frameworks, toolboxes, and best practices that member librarians can utilize in NC community colleges. Assessment, to make recommendations for data gathering and to analyze and evaluate the collected data and to acknowledge successful initiatives and projects at member libraries and within the organization. Advocacy, to challenge orthodoxy and promote change making and cultivate a culture of belonging in collaboration with the NCCCLA Advocacy Committee and to benefit all NC Community College libraries in the communities we serve. And it has been approved by the NCCCLA Executive Board on September 23rd, 2020.
The NCCCLA Equity Subcommittee Action Plans are comprised of our equity statement, and the equity statement, our plan was to create a statement that proclaims NCCCLA's commitment to equity and support to those of marginalized groups. Also, equity collection development, to encourage equity through print and electronic collection development. And finally, our transition into a standing committee to better support equity initiatives and cultivate a shift inclusiveness in community college libraries.
I would like to also add to this slide that we are, again, working on our bylaws this summer. And so that will, of course, turn us into a full committee. We'll make that transition. And so that's something to keep in mind as we are talking about the action plans of the subcommittee. So, hosting racial equity training. Library administrations across the country are holding their teams accountable. Partnering with state and national racial equity facilitators have helped to increase healthier and longstanding relationships within their community. I have seen this increase, especially in public libraries, but I'm really seeing it in academic libraries. And it makes me proud to see that we're making this commitment to making everyone feel comfortable using the library and creating a welcoming space for all. And I think it's important that we host these partnerships, whether it's, you know, internal or external programs. I would like to see more moving forward, but I will say that we're doing a great job with this increase in racial equity training.
Another equity practice is to partner with community college professionals. Use this opportunity to learn what other library professionals are implementing in their libraries. Borrow initiatives and tailor them to fit your community's needs. Evaluate your program outcome assessments to see what's working. And actively seek guidance from equity teams on your campus to better support your community.
And another way to make sure you're creating equitable spaces in your library is to look at your community. I think sometimes more than often we have the community talking to us, but we don't always know how to read that. So take the time to listen and learn from your community users through your team. This is a great way to partner with your circulation team to learn about items that are circulating, items that are being suggested. speak with your reference librarians about research assistant requests. And if you are finding that you're having to put in more interlibrary loan requests to get access to those resources during the times when you're having to go back and renew subscriptions for databases or having to purchase books, look into other database options. That way you're fully servicing your patrons. Monitor the posts that are most engaged on your social media. Maybe it's because I use social media a lot. And I actually post on behalf of our library here at Pitt. I am constantly watching those numbers. I'm looking at the time that users are most engaged with our posts. I'm looking at the content that I'm posting, whether it's just an image or if I have just the post itself without the image, if I'm creating video content. I will say that looking at the analytical data has been really helpful for me. Also, they're talking to you by just simply telling you their needs. And this is a way to help you make the library more inclusive. So be sure to listen.
So we would like to take this opportunity now to ask for your help in answering our question of, in what ways can NCCCLA continue to encourage equity practices in community college libraries?
I want to ask moderators, is it okay if we go ahead and turn off the recording so everyone feels comfortable to share?
Sure. I will turn the recording off now.
Thank you.